Hello dear viewers and welcome to RTD's English News Edition. The top stories for tonight are: the Djiboutian Coast Guard celebrates their 70th anniversary under the aegis of the Prime Minister. The Minister of Interior made a statement for the legislative election schedule. Thank you for joining us in our newsroom. Under the chairmanship of His Excellency Muhammad Ali Hamad, the second sitting of the 70th National Assembly Legislature took place today in the headquarters of the Parliament's chamber. The Prime Minister Abdul Qadir Kamil Muhammad, the member of the government and all parliamentarians had examined seven bills. The bill number 217 on the recognition of studies, certifications, diplomas, degrees and other titles of higher education in African states. The bill number 207 on the promotion and protection of the rights of persons with special needs. The bill number 208 on the ratification of the loan agreement between the Republic of Djibouti and the Saudi Fund for the development and financing of the Djibouti-Tejera Road Rehabilitation Project, as well as the bill number 209 on the promotion and protection of the rights of seniors, bill number 213 on the safety of the railways operation, bill number 214 on the ratification of the memorandum of understanding with the government of the Republic of Djibouti and the government of the Federal Democratic Republic of Ethiopia on the creation of a common border, and finally bill number 215 to approve the financial accounts of the National Office for Water Supply and Sanitation of Djibouti, ONEAD, for the 2015 financial year. In addition, this plenary session is special because it marks the end of the 70th legislature. The President of the National Assembly, Muhammad Ali Hamad, made a historic speech in which he mentioned the merits of the work accomplished during his last 5 years. The head of the National Assembly also took this opportunity to summarize the great achievements of this parliament. He said that throughout this legislature, the elected representatives of the people have worthily and with self-sacrifice acquitted of their work with more than 220 laws up to date, more than 240 meetings of the permanent commissions, 7 extraordinary sessions, 3 motions of resolution, 100 of questions of the news in the government, 5 of the political general declaration, 10 budget orientation debates in the commissions, to name just a few. These laws have undoubtedly helped strengthen our democracy and strengthen our national economy, said the President of the National Assembly. Continuing with the national news, the Djiboutian Coast Guards celebrated today the 70th anniversary of the institute under the high patronage of the Prime Minister Abdul Qadir Kamil Muhammad. This institution is entirely dedicated to the surveillance of the maritime area of the Republic of Djibouti. On his arrival at the place, the Prime Minister was welcomed by the Minister of Equipment and Transport, Muhammad Abdul Qadir Musa, and the commander of the Coast Guards, Colonel Waisim Al-Bukhari. Before taking his seat at the official tribune, the Prime Minister reviewed a Coast Guard unit. In addition to the Prime Minister and the Minister of Transport, the ceremony was attended by several members of the government, the Chief of the General Staff, Zakaria Sheikh Ibrahim, the Director General of the Police, Colonel Abdullahi Abdi, the Ambassador from Japan to Djibouti, the Ambassador of the European Union, and many other plenipotentiaries. A demonstration of martial arts was made by the commandos of the Coast Guards. And on the occasion of the 70th anniversary of the Coast Guards, in his speech, the Colonel of the Coast Guards welcomed the recruitment of 360 new youth after their success in military training. During his intervention, the Minister of Equipment and Transport praised at length the work done and the essential role that Coast Guards play in the maritime security. For his part, the Prime Minister Abdul Qadir Kamil Mohamed hailed in his speech the effectiveness of the Djibouti Coast Guards for maritime safety and security and the protection of the marine environment. The Prime Minister said that 20,000 ships are passing through Djiboutian waters in the Bab el-Mandeb Strait, and it's essential to guarantee the free movement of goods and people. After the official speeches, Colonel Waiz Omar Bukhari is awarded by the Prime Minister the Medal of Defense of Territory with the bronze. Then the Minister of Equipment and Transport awarded the Commander Muhammad Adawi Muhammad the Medal of Honor of the Nation with the bronze band. Several civilian contract staff were raised the night Guards of the National Order, June 27, 1977. The ceremony of the 70th anniversary of the creation of the Coast Guard ended around the launch of the seaside in a naval parade unfolded before the rise. At the approach of the legislative elections of February 23, the Minister of Interior, Hassan Omar Mohamed, has in his statement made to the press today announced the timing of the elections. Initially, the Minister of Interior indicated that all arrangements were made at the level of his department for the holding of these elections under the best conditions, namely the revision of the electoral lists as well as the provisions at the voting offices. Interior Minister Hassan Omar also announced that voter registration cards are now available in all prefectures and polling stations, and that the prefecture administration has been strengthened to ensure optimal distribution. The Minister of the Interior on this occasion invited his fellow citizens not to wait until the last day to collect their voter cards in order to fulfill their civic duty. The members of the Electoral Commission headed by its president have met this morning with the Prefecture of Djibouti to inspect the conduct of the pre-electoral activities. The members of the commission first had an interview with the Prefect of Djibouti on the voting procedures and the administrative process undertaken for this purpose. They have then took the direction of the districts 4 and 5 to check the lists of electoral posted on the board according to polling station. And at the end, the president of the commission expressed his satisfaction at the smooth running of pre-electoral process, and he considered that the voting conditions, particularly technical and material conditions, were well met to facilitate the voters' access to the lists. And like the other regions of the interior in the capital, the prefect of Arta has made available to the public the electoral cards. For the administrative center, the voting counters are open to the public on the premises of the prefecture of the region of Arta. Arta Prefecture has also set up a mobile team for the distribution of electoral cards in remote areas of the region. Continuing with other news of this edition, the Minister of Energy in charge of Natural Resources, Yunus Ali Gedi, received in his cabinet an important delegation led by the CEO of the Chinese company GCL Group, Mr. Zhu Kongshan. And let's not forget that PolyGCL, a joint venture between GCL Group and China Poly Group, leads the Sino-Ethiopia Djiboutian gas mega project. The gas extracted in Ethiopia will be piped 700 kilometers to the Merjok, where a liquefaction plant will be built that will produce up to 10 million tons of liquefied natural gas per year. The visit of Mr. Zhu Kongshan follows the signing in November 2017 of a memorandum of understanding between the Republic of Djibouti and the Polish GCL company, as well as the visit to China of the President of the Republic, Xi Jinping, during the same month. Mr. Zhu Kongshan reiterated the major interest of this project for both sites and is now part of the Chinese New Silk Road strategy called One Belt, One Road. Both sides reaffirmed their willingness to move forward in the negotiations of the legal contracts and to conclude an agreement on a win-win basis in the near future. The Minister of Higher Education yesterday organized a workshop at the University of Djibouti on the perspective of higher education and scientific research in Djibouti in partnership with the World Bank. The aim of this workshop was to promote higher education in the socio-economic development process in Djibouti, as well as the resurgence of an interest in higher education. This workshop saw the participation of the Minister of Higher Education and Research, Dr. Nabil Mohamed Ahmed, and many students of the university and dean of the university. Initiatives such as Centers of Excellence have established partnership for skills in applied science, engineering, and technology, which are part of the various efforts to improve higher education in Djibouti. In his speech, the minister recalled the will of the President of the Republic, His Excellency Ismail Merguele, to make Djibouti a country where education like the higher education opens a real opportunities of development and creation of wealth through trainings turned toward the future and in line with the priorities of the country. Last Saturday, the Minister of Housing and Environment, Mr. Moussa Ahmed, visited Kalaf Drilling in the Tejara region. On the spot, the Minister of Housing, Moussa Mohamed, was welcomed by the Prefect of Tejara, Abdul Malik Mohamed Borgeita, and the President of the Regional Council, Omar Hussein. This new Kalaf Drilling will supply water to the surrounding population and will also allow the development of agro-pastoral perimeter of 10 hectares in this locality. On the international news, in France, tensions in prisons continue. The prison guards movement is blocking 114 prisons Monday morning, according to the FO Penitentiary. The unions will be received Monday afternoon by the Minister of Justice, faced with tensions in prisons. Guards call for total blockage of prisons. The prison administration speaks of 55 prisons affected by the guards movement. Nicole Belloubet, the keeper of the seals, announced in the night that she will receive on Monday union organizations after the rejection of government proposals in a climate of tension fueled by repeated assaults. The minister also called for the responsibility of everyone to ensure the safety in France and functioning of penitentiary institutions are assured. We're here. We close this edition. Thank you for joining us on RTD and have a good night.